Didn't Miss Sue Ellen tell you about my store?
Did she? I don't remember. Have you a store, this?
Won't you come in, look around a bit? I don't suppose it looks like much to a lady, but I can't help being proud of it.
You're not making money?
Well, I can't complain. In fact, I'm mighty encouraged. Folks tell me I'm just a born merchant. It won't be long now before Miss Sue Ellen and I can marry.
Well, you're doing as well as all that?
Yes, I am, Miss Scarlet. I'm no millionaire yet, but I have cleared $1,000 already.
And Lumber too?
Well, that's only a sideline.
A sideline, Frank? With all the good Georgia pine around Atlanta, and all this building going on?
Well, all that takes money, Miss Scarlet, and I got to be thinking about buying a home.
What would you want a home for?
For Miss Sue Ellen and me to set up housekeeping.
Here in Atlanta? You'd want to bring her to Atlanta, wouldn't you? There wouldn't be much help in that for Tara.
I don't rightly know what you mean, Miss Scarlet.
I don't mean a thing. Frank, how'd you like to drive me out to my Aunt Bitty's?
Oh, nothing could give me more pleasure, Miss Scarlet.
I think you'd better stay for supper too. I'm sure Aunt Bitty would be agreeable and I know I'd like a good long visit with you.
Oh, you act on me just like a tonic, Miss Scarlet. And will you tell me all the news, all the news of Miss Sue Ellen? What's the matter, Miss Scarlet? Miss Sue Ellen's not ill, is she?
Oh, no, no. I thought surely she had written you. I guess she was ashamed to write to you. She should be ashamed. Oh, how awful to have such a mean sister.
You must tell me, Miss Scarlet. Don't leave me on the tender hooks,